This is the Ludlow Porch Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, broadcasting from the Falcon Inn and Conference Center in Suwanee, Georgia. A low show brought to you in part by the Fairburn Eye Clinic, by Folks Restaurants, and by Cooper Weight Loss Centers. The toll-free lines are now open at 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, Fun Seekers. Hi, y'all. It is a great day to be alive. It is muggy, but if you could just stay inside and look at it, you're going to be all right. We are talking about myths or old wives' tales, if you're there. Started this with a story from a Newhouse News Service about some of the myths that keep coming back to us, none of them true, but keep coming back to us over the years, and you've all heard these. But maybe more than one generation has heard these. Here's one for our generation. I read this in a magazine and actually put it on the air about the scuba diver after a big warehouse fire. Sometimes they say it's in Europe, usually in France. The account I read was out west someplace. Workers poking around through the rubble find a diver complete with air tanks. Supposedly a helicopter scooped up the water from a nearby lake to put out a fire, and there he was. Another one is about the lady on the elevator and a man with a dog, a big imposing man, who said, "Down, lady," and she drops to the floor. About the criminal ring who is taking kidneys from live people to sell. All you've heard them all. Everything from the beaver, Jerry Mathers, being killed in Vietnam, to Paul McCartney being dead, to put a horsehair in a glass of whiskey and it'll turn into a snake. We've heard all of those, and there are a lot more out there, like toasting bread takes the calories out, or broken cookies contain no calories, too, for the dieters of the world. Let's hear yours, Cleveland, Tennessee, and our cleaning woman. Hello, beautiful lady. How you doing?
Good morning, Ludlow. I am doing so well today.
Good.
I have a couple here that I used to think were just bunk and have discovered from personal experience that they're not.
Okay.
One, I used to hear when I was young, don't mix bleach and ammonia because it can kill you. That is very, very true.
You mean the fumes from it?
The fumes. Okay. At the very least, it's brain damage.
Okay.
Okay? I found that out one time when I was in my teens and ended up on the concrete floor face first. So that's very true. And something else that I used to think was total bunk was this thing that we've talked about it in detail with Freimeyer and stuff about the signs of the moon and whatever.
Yeah.
And how it can affect your garden and even the dirt, the water, whatever.
Or your hair growth.
Yeah, I think that there really is something to it, and we just don't understand what it is exactly. Because it does control the tides and everything,
well,
too.
Well, yeah, you would think if it controls the tides, it could control some human action.
Yeah. Or at least influence. Maybe not totally control, but, you know, maybe we should think about it.
Yeah, I think police officers could tell us a lot about what the full moon does to people's activity and people in emergency rooms, that sort of thing.
Yeah, do you know they had a whole episode on ER, and the name of the episode was, it was a full moon.
Oh, no.
And that, it was a great, great episode. And I have a short list here of three, what I guess I would consider myths that us mothers would like to believe, having to do with eating.
Uh-huh.
Anything you eat while standing up has no calories. I've always heard this all my life from my mother. Anything you finish off a child's plate contains absolutely no calories and probably has a slimming effect on
them. Yes,
yes. Any food that you test before it is put into the serving dish that it's going to be put in for supper, as long as it's still in the pot and you're just testing it, there's no calories.
That's the reason there are no fat chefs.
That's right. And, you know, talking about the mouth thing that Patty was talking about, the version I heard had to do with remain nameless large chicken chain with a deep fried mouth.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that one went around here in this area for the longest time.
Oh, and the hamburger place, everybody's been a victim of that.
Yeah, it's something, but the biggest one to me was the one you talked about earlier with the lady in the raincoat or whatever, and she disappeared.
Yeah, there are 10 versions of that, I guess, for 10 parts of the country, and people were saying that really happened to my uncle.
Do you remember the old radio program of the history theater type thing, where the man was driving down the road and a man in a raincoat, even though it was not raining, the man kept appearing in front of him, and the man had on, you know, like a London fog coat with raindrops on the shoulders, and he kept appearing before this man no matter how fast he drove or where he went.
Yeah, it was Peter Falk.
Was that who it was?
Columbo. With a raincoat.
Oh, yeah, well.
I'm kidding.
No, but this is on tape. I heard it when I checked out a set of the old radio programs not long ago.
Mm-hmm.
On the Mystery Theater, I think it was, or Suspense, that's what it was. Remember, designed to keep you in.
Tales carefully.
Suspense. Right.
Tales carefully calculated to keep you in suspense.
And we need the organ music in the background. Yeah, but that's it. I'm out here enjoying my porch and watering my flowers. I've got an afternoon job today, so this morning I've been cleaning my aquarium and listening to you.
Good for you. You take care. I'll talk to you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. More right after this. Have you noticed how many auto companies are trying to build cars that look like Jeeps? You and I both know that they're not Jeeps, not by a long shot. And have you noticed how many dealerships are trying to take a page out of Jasper Jeep's book? I mean, low prices, no haggle, no hassle, one-price shopping. Don't you buy it, gang, because there's only one Jasper Jeep Dodge Chrysler Plymouth, and their one price, no haggle, no hassle shopping has made them the biggest Jeep dealership anywhere. Huge inventory. Featuring all the new design Cherokees for 97 at prices you're going to love. So, when it is time for you to buy your next new car, truck, or van, I want you to do this. You go see the nicest folks I know, Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth, in beautiful Jasper, Georgia. Now, they're open Monday through Saturday, 8 to 7, but never, ever on Sunday. Jasper Jeep in Jasper, Georgia. No matter where you live, they should be your automobile dealership.
The rumors are true. Turner Field has a pitching game that measures how fast you throw, and how accurate you are, and how long the bystanders laugh. Well, not really, I mean about the laughing part.
The rumors are true. The food's so good at Turner Field, you'll think you've died and gone to heaven.
I'll take a big, fat, grilled Italian sausage.
Even if your tastes are a bit more down to earth.
On a brat with sauerkraut and mustard.
Depending on who we're playing, there'll be epicurean delights from around the league. Philly cheesesteaks, Dodger dogs, even Maryland crab cakes when the Orioles are in town.
Oh, I wish we'd play somebody from France.
France?
I think that's where they make Pez.
Oh.
New Turner Field. It's everything you've heard. For Braves tickets now, call Ticketmaster at
404-249-6400. 1-800-572-8255. Myths, urban or otherwise. Newberry County, South Carolina, and Jim. Good morning, Jim.
How you doing, Mr. Bullock?
I'm doing good, big guy.
I got one for you.
All right.
On the Babe Ruth thing.
All right.
There's a video that hit the little machine on top of the television. I can't even think what the name of it is. I'm way up here in the National Forest, and I'm not at home. I can't see it. You know what I'm talking about, where you play your tapes.
Your VCR?
Yeah.
Yeah,
right.
Okay, yeah.
I was wanting to say VHF, but that's airplane stuff. That won't work.
Yeah.
Anyway, there's one out, and I'm, like I said, I'm not at home. The title of it is either The Babe Ruth Story or just simply Babe Ruth.
Uh-huh.
And it goes through his whole career with the Yankees. He did it in its own tape.
Its own tape?
Yes, sir.
See, I didn't know that.
Yes, sir. Its own tape. I got it. And it's in his VCR, so I'm sure.
Okay.
It's large, but it's in there.
Now, is this a movie or a documentary?
A documentary.
Okay. All right, well, that's good to know. Because that's
no,
one
this
of the...
is no movie. This is live stuff. I mean,
yeah.
Film and all.
Right.
Actually, him.
Well, I'm glad to know that because...
He did it.
All right, well, that's good.
If I'm not mistaken, the pitcher was Charlie Root, who was one of the best of that day.
I have no idea who the pitcher was or even who they were playing.
I think it was Charlie Root. I'm not positive.
All right.
I think that's who it was.
Okay, I really appreciate that, my man.
You betcha.
You take care of yourself. Let's go to Griffin, Georgia, talk to Papa John. Hello, Papa John.
Double fire, Ludlow.
How you doing, my friend?
Doing great.
I'm glad to hear from you.
Ludlow, I got a good one for you.
All right.
Back in the early 1900s, especially the people up in the Carolinas will enjoy this. Back in the early 1900s, a lot of states sold burial insurance. And this would supply you with a casket or a vault or, mm-hmm. or a cemetery plot. And some of the companies, especially in Georgia, that was forbidden. Here, if you had one of those type policies, rather than giving you the casket or the steel vault, they would give you cash, about $150 rather than a casket. So mm-hmm. when a person moved into the state of Georgia, these agents would go out and try to get them to convert it from a burial policy over to a cash policy. Of course, some of the older folks wouldn't do it, but they had one particular agent that was just setting the woods on fire, and they couldn't understand why. So during one of their little company conventions, they got him up on stage to tell how he did it. He said, well, it's real simple. Said, I go up there and I tell him, said, look, have you ever thought how they can sell a casket for 5 cents a week? And the people would say, well, no. He said, well, you know, when they bury somebody, they'll have them out there at the funeral plot over the grave, and the preacher will say a few good words, then they'll lead the family away, and then later on, after they buried him, bring them back. People would say, yeah. He said, well, what they got, said, when they lead them away, said they got a lever on the side of that casket. Said they'll just pull a lever and the body will drop down. They'll throw the casket back in her. So they'll use the thing 100 or 200 times before they have to buy another. And you talking about getting fired on the spot, but that poor boy got fired right there.
And how much of that you reckon is true, and how much you reckon is a great story? Doesn't make any difference, does it?
Sounds good to me.
It sounds good to me, too, buddy. You take care of yourself.
All right,
I'll talk to you.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. A lever on a trap door. Oh, 1-800-572-8255. This is Ludlow and Denny, and you're listening, by golly, to the Fun Seekers Radio Network. Hi, Fun Seekers. Ludlow Porch with a question for you. You going to be too busy to cook tonight? Lowndes County, Georgia, and Aubrey on the radio. Hello, Aubrey.
Good morning, Ludlow.
Good morning.
I got a couple of them I've been thinking of since I've been on hold,
mm-hmm.
and then I'll get the one I was asking Denny about. I had heard that if you play certain rock and roll records backwards, you'll get messages like a song by Queen and another one Bites the Dust. If you play it backwards, it says, decide to smoke marijuana. If you listen to the song Stairway to Heaven, it says, it urges people to worship Satan. And actually, I'd heard that the Beatles started that rumor themselves that Paul McCartney was dead to play on people's sympathies so they could, I don't know.
Yeah.
Make more money. That one, the album covers from the Beatles, I don't remember which album it was, that the it kind of led you to believe that Paul McCartney was dead, and that I think the White Album, I believe it was, that they said if you played it backwards, they were constantly saying that Paul McCartney was dead. And that's what I've heard.
Well, I've heard all of those things, too, and who knows.
But I'll tell you one thing. Well, I know John Lennon said.
Yeah.
And if, I'm gonna be mean. But you know, if he wouldn't have been killed by one of his biggest fans, I think eventually Yoko Ono singing would have done it.
Well, he was killed by a nut, and that's pretty well documented. All right, Aubrey.
I want to get to the one I was telling Benny about.
Okay.
I had heard that Coca-Cola, early on, had cocaine in it, and that's how it got its name. And I was wondering if that was true.
No, I don't think so. And I tell you what, I talked to the Coca-Cola historian, and he denied the whole thing. It's some years ago, so I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. Different world back then. And we'll talk to you, Big Aubrey. You take care of yourself as we go to Covington, Georgia, and talk to Mark on the radio. Hello, Mark.
Yes, Ludlow.
How are you?
Just fine, thank you.
Good.
I wanted to shed a little more light on this Glenn Miller situation. A lady called in a while ago, said she read it in a local paper.
Yeah.
That he died in the house of ill repute. Now, this thing is crazy.
No, what she said was there was a hooker on the airplane.
Oh, no. The airplane was a little two-seat airplane, reconnaissance. And he was flying from his place in England to Paris to put on a show for the GIs for Christmas 1944.
Okay.
Now, the plane never arrived in Paris.
I understand that.
Yeah. So how the devil could he have been in a Paris brothel? It just doesn't make sense.
Not at all. It sounds like it's getting bigger and more out of hand, doesn't it?
Yeah. Now, here's a little more clean joke for you.
All right.
Warren Lubber, is the ocean messy? Sea captain, no, it's a tidy place, high tide, low tide. You like that?
I like that. You take care, Mark.
Thank you.
Talk to you. Thank you, sir. Be good. 1-800-572-8255 as we talk to Vince in Greenville, South Carolina. Hello, Vincent.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How are you?
Wonderful.
Good.
I was thinking about some of these stories about the food, especially when you eat an apple. If you find a worm, or even if you find a half a worm, it's all right. Nothing much you can do about that.
It still keeps the doctor away, yeah.
If you open a can or a jar that has a label on it, you can wreck a whole industry. That's the funny thing about the people, you know, could open...
Do you remember the big cranberry scare from a few years back?
Yeah. It went through a lot of products. Tuna fish was, that was on the list for a while.
But as I recall, the cranberry scare came right before Thanksgiving or the holiday season, and just was devastating to people in that business.
Yeah, well, see, that's what kicked it off. They found out if you can do it to cranberries, you can do it to anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll bet you anything, if you started opening cans today, you could open cans for 100 years and you'd never find anything wrong with anything.
Exactly.
It's the strangest world we live in.
It is.
Can I tell you a story about my brother Sam?
Yeah.
This comes under the, we're rather loose today, the category.
Okay.
But I talked to Sam last week. He's the youngest of all my older brothers. He's 80.
All right.
He said he just finished up the Pennsylvania Olympic Games. And there was 146 contestants, and he got the highest score. Now, the Senior Citizen Olympics starts at age 55,
uh-huh.
And it has the 5-year categories. And he's now in the 80-year category. He won 4 gold medals and 4 silver medals. And such categories as table tennis. Now, if you keep score, that's called ping pong. That's called table tennis. If you don't keep score, it's ping pong.
All right.
And horseshoes, he got 9 ringers in a row. And shuffleboard, that's a 22-foot table shuffleboard.
Yeah.
He won on that. And darts, I don't know too much about darts, but there is an official Olympics distance that you have to throw these. You get a score of 210 to start. And then he only threw 4 darts and wiped out the score. I don't understand that very well either. I asked him about longevity. What's your philosophy of longevity? He said, I don't understand them big words because I never went to school. What's that mean? I said, well, are you in good health? Why are you in such good health? He said, well, I stay active and I don't take any pills. I never took any pills, and he said I was never in the hospital. But he stays active. He was never in sports either. He's just hunting and fishing and hiking, and he eats mushrooms and, you know, wild berries and all that good stuff.
Tree bark.
He's 80 years old, and he's so active. He gets up early, and he's on the go all the time.
That's wonderful.
And he's got all these medals. He's been doing this almost every year now since he got to be 70s, and he started when he was 7.
Great story. Glad you called, buddy. Take care. More conversation right after this. Well, I hope by now you got big plans for a summer vacation, and I hope you're going to let my friends at Bavajet make this the best vacation of your life. Going to Florida, Fort Walton Beach, Jacksonville, Orlando, Tampa, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm, or Fort Myers, you make sure you go with Bavajet. Take the whole family with you, the best vacation of your life, and you're going to save big money with my buddies at Bavajet. Don't forget low fares every day, everywhere they fly. Vacation time, gang.
Does a lack of mobility have you feeling like a prisoner? Break out with a Rascal electric scooter or power chair from Electric Mobility. Go when you want to, without relying on others, indoors or out. Shop, visit, dine out, right around your house and yard with comfort and style. Rascals feature easy-to-use just one-hand controls, super comfort seating choices, a built-in battery charger, and are easy to take apart for transporting in a car or van. Expensive? No way! With no money down in our special financing plan, you could be riding a Rascal for around $2 a day. Isn't your freedom worth it? Plus, if you qualify, Medicare or private insurance may reimburse up to 100% of the purchase price. Right now, you can try out a Rascal for free in the comfort of your own home. Call for your free home demonstration of the Rascal now. We'll send you a free catalog and tell you about our special introductory money-saving offer.
Call toll-free 1-800-340-4455. That's 1-800-340-4455.
Now talk to the amazing Bulldog Betty on the radio. Hello, amazing.
Good morning, amazing sir. Amazing LP, as it were.
How you doing?
This is the Luster Potentate, I trust.
It is.
The fettle is a little damp and muggy, sort of, I guess.
It is muggy.
And muggy fettles are bad.
Oh, no, I mean, nothing any worse than
you
that.
You have not had, I mean, a heat rash don't enter into it. And you've had a muggy fettle? Boy, they... I'm doing well, and how about your darling?
I am wide open today.
I sort of guessed that. I really did. Danny's taste in music. Eclectic is a word that I just like the sound of. I have no idea what it means. But I sort of think it goes along with Danny's taste in music, because a few minutes ago when he and that drunken gypsy had at it again, I thought, uh-oh, we're going down the hill. But this last breaker was pretty decent.
Yeah.
I mean, the child amazes.
Something for everybody is our motto.
And if you don't like it, that's all right too, Leo.
That's exactly right.
By the way, and this, I had not meant to bring this up. You probably heard it on the news. Did you hear that Canada now has a successor to Lorena Bobbitt?
No.
Only this one did was not thrown out the car window, flushed. On the news one day, one morning later, or one day last week, I never did see it in the paper, but I heard it on the, you know, infallible news station.
Yes, uh-huh.
This old gal was not going to have things fixed up later on.
No, she was,
He survived. Her husband, or whoever he was, not a good friend, I would think, did survive. Talking about old stories and things that make the rounds.
Yeah.
And many, many times have we heard, never happens to somebody that we actually know, not the neighbor next door, but it was My neighbor's daughter-in-law's second cousin.
Yeah,
she's over in three subdivisions down.
Mm-hmm.
Went out to take her child to daycare or to school or something and came back, and the family, faithful family Doberman, who was such a good watchdog, had a human finger in his mouth. Obviously,
yeah. Yeah, we talked about that. Denny and I talked about that earlier today.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that.
Didn't know if that had been, but you know that periodically that surfaces again,
mm-hmm.
and like I say, it's never anybody that you know for sure, but someone close.
Yeah.
Slightly
believable.
Yes, it depends. Another thing, and I know this to be a fact. Of course, when I say anything to my loved ones, it's my nearest and dearest. About being a young student, a young nursing student, this is an oxymoron, you know, there ain't no way. I mean, Stone Mountain is young. But anyway, surprisingly enough, at that point in time, we did have anesthesia and didn't have witch doctors and stuff.
Real hospitals?
Yes, sir, real hospitals and ambulances.
Uh-huh.
They didn't have these funny sounding sirens on them, but we had them.
Yeah.
We had an OB supervisor. She was on the evening shift. When the moon was full, that dear old soul would come bustling in, and she had the type of figure that did bustle well.
Uh-huh.
Get the emergency instruments, get all the emergency things cleaned up. We're going to need it. The moon's full. We laughed at her. At 9 o'clock that night, we had labor patients up and down both sides of the hall, behind screens. Private rooms had all of a sudden been turned.
Yeah.
We were hatching them. Wholesale.
And she was dealing with experience.
Well, we laughed at her, and then later on, a smart aleck who at that, you know, you've been nursing students, as you know from your barber coming in, been in training about a year or so, you're dangerous.
Uh-huh.
With enough knowledge. The moon, of course, controls the tides, and there is definitely a connection between the tide and the amniotic fluid.
Yeah.
So there is a basis for that.
Yeah, absolutely. I believe that.
One more old wives' tale which needs to be put to rest, and then I'm going to let you go because I'm probably going after Bobby Cox with a knife or something today.
All right.
Mark Wars can pitch more than one inning when he's got it and he's throwing that 98-mile-an-hour fastball for strikes. You don't have to pull him out for a pinch hitter and put in by Lecky. Promptly.
And that's not an old wives' tale, is it?
That ball that a watch you or whatever reason, that ball is probably still trapped.
That's what they say, it's still climbing.
Probably past making about 30 minutes.
Last time anybody saw it, it's still climbing.
Yes.
You have a great day, my love.
Take care of your bad self. We'll talk to you later.
I'm going to do it.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Let us talk to Edgar on the radio. Good morning, Edgar.
Hello, Dr. Laura.
How you doing?
I'm having problems with my wife.
You sure are.
Hey, I'm on the wrong front, Mark. How you doing, Ludlow?
I'm doing good, old friend. How you been?
Well, after my 5 bypass surgery, I'm coming along real well.
A new man, are you?
I tell you what.
Well, that's good.
My wife thought to change the lock from the door because she thought I'd come in the other night. She thought I was somebody else.
All right.
I don't know if it's been talked about, but back when I was a young man, I heard a myth about McDonald's were selling horse meat instead of hamburgers.
Yeah, that as we said earlier, that, you know, that pretty much covered all of the... all of the hamburger people at one time or another.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then, too, I also heard that Nat King Cole got killed by a white woman because she didn't want to date him or something. Did you hear anything about that?
Absolutely not true.
Yeah, I didn't think so. Anyway.
Absolutely not true.
Well, let me tell you something that is true.
All right.
I heard this on another radio station. They were talking about that they had some opening for T-shirts in New York. So they had... 756 graduates.
For teachers? You said teachers?
Teachers, uh-huh.
Okay.
So they had 756 come out of the school and ready to go to work. So they only needed to fill about 21 jobs, so they didn't know what to do, so they decided to give all of them 11th grade history tests. Do you know how many passed that?
Out of how many?
756.
No.
221. That's unbelievable, isn't it? And another true story. Michael Jackson was in a hotel. This was several years back. And he was coming down on the elevator with this other woman. And he had his guard dog with him. And she was beginning to misbehave a little bit. And so He said, "Lady, get down on the floor." The lady says, "I'm too old to get on the floor, but you can have my purse, sir."
See, that's not true either.
That's not true?
Nope.
That never happened, huh?
No, that was, that's in the article that I started out, and the guy who they usually say is has the dog Reggie Jackson, but sometimes they say Jesse Jackson, and sometimes Michael Jackson. So, not true, but a fun story.
Yeah, well, I'm up and about, so I'll be calling you more often.
Glad you're better, old boy.
Okay, talk to you later, pal.
Take care of yourself.
All right, bye.
1-800-572-8255. More right after this. Hi, Fun Seekers. Ludlow Porch. My buddy's at the Blue Willow Inn. Listen, when you get ready for that special meal, you think of the Blue Willow Inn. Superb southern food, beautiful surroundings, and service like you've always dreamed of having. Fried chicken, fried steak. If it's southern, they make it, and they make it better than anybody else. The Blue Willow Inn. You stop by and tell them Ludlow Porch sent you. Oh, you want to know where it is? It's in Social Circle, Georgia. Where else would it be? I want to tell you about my friends at the Fairburn Eye Clinic. Best care available, whether it's a simple eye exam, new glasses, contacts, eye surgery, or a second opinion. Easy to talk to. Good folks. Been going to them for years. Matter of fact, my whole family goes to them. They'll answer all the questions.
Well, I was raised on country music. Songs about drinking and cheating and losing. Real sad songs that would make a grown man cry. Songs about pain and unemployment. Songs that interfere with life's enjoyment. You sing about these things, you're singing about my life. If you take a country song and you play it backwards, you sober up and you don't cheat on your wife.
1-800-572-8255, Statesboro, Georgia. And Peter on the radio. Hello, Peter.
Good morning, Lonnie.
Good morning, big boy. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good.
You have a good weekend?
Great weekend, yeah.
That rain, all that clouds and everything seems to have pulled out for a while.
Yeah, I hope. But boy, it is muggy. You walk outside for 30 seconds and you can feel it.
Well, you know, it must be the heat because, it looks kind of cloudy, like it threatens a little bit. And by 1 o'clock, when it really heats up, the hot air just absorbs all that moisture.
Yeah.
I have missed small portions of your show this morning, and so I don't know whether you're talking about things that people say have happened that never happened, or both, or vice versa.
Well, primarily it's like old wives' tales we're talking about, everything from the fact that Elvis is alive to the fact that Paul McCartney's dead.
Well, I tell you. I think a better rumor, if we're going to participate in those, would be that I'd much rather see Lewis alive.
Yeah.
I'm reading The Last Bus to Albuquerque, and it's real funny, real touching.
Yeah, it is.
The two things that came to my mind, though, is that, and I guess we'll just turn these around a little bit, that the landing on the moon never occurred.
Oh, yeah, there was a big group behind that. I say behind that. I mean, a large number of folks bought the fact that those scenes were shot in a Holiday Inn someplace.
Or in a big... The thing that we heard, and maybe this was Spacewalks, it was in Sealand aquarium or something.
Yeah.
You know, where they were acting weightless, and they say, "Oh, look, you can see the bubbles there." and of course, it started again with this Mars lander.
Yeah.
You know, that's shot either on some back light or in Arizona someplace.
Yeah, special effects.
And, you know, I guess you can get in to to all these things about different people who supposedly were killed. And no, they're not really dead. Like the last thing on Jimmy Stewart played him, Glenn Miller.
Yeah.
You know, you can't really go back and disprove these things. You just got to deal with them and say, okay, you know, I guess it's kind of like the campaign finance irregularities. You know, you just got to proceed with the facts and just discount.
Well, once people are not interested very much in facts. If they can get one of these rumors to keep on, they'll even add a little bit to it. You know, just to kind of help things along.
But does this come with the territory?
I guess that's all I can figure. They, you know, the prevailing thing about Elvis was, you know, was that he was tired of having no privacy and all that. So he faked this whole thing. And as I said then and say now, the guy in the coffin was apparently not in on this. Nobody told him when he went to work there that they were going to have to kill him.
the Mark Twain thing Huck? No, I think it was Tom Sawyer that got buried.
Yeah.
You know, they thought he... Maybe that's what fueled everybody's mind to thinking in this manner, that there actually could be somebody that's in that coffin.
Yeah.
Or maybe nobody that's in that coffin.
Yeah.
And it's funny, but got to be taken with a great dose of salt.
Do you remember all of the hoorah about the Tsar's youngest child, Anastasia?
Yes.
And after that lady died, and this was a 50 or 60 year thing.
Yeah.
After she died, it was proven by those tests that she was not related to those people at all. And the same with Jesse James. You know, all of these things. His mother said this, yeah, and the doctor said this, and it turns out that was old Jesse.
Well, you know, what's funny to me is that. My father was a classic of this age in the belief that science was like a source of truth that was you couldn't question.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, now we're getting into the situation where it doesn't matter what science says, it's what you think.
Yeah.
That's most important.
Or the latest rumor.
Well, that what you think, because you can disprove. I mean, you can go in and say all this joke about who's burying Grant's tomb.
Yeah.
You could go up there and pull a tissue sample and that's Grant. And there would still be people walking around saying, well, Grant's not really buried in that tomb. That's just, you know, they're just trying to put this over on us. He was really transported by aliens to Alpha Centauri.
Exactly. Which is just outside of Roswell, New Mexico. It's a suburb of Roswell. And the people on the Roswell thing who actually thought that the PFCs, privates and corporals involved in all of this, were sworn to secrecy. You try swearing somebody to secrecy who just saw an alien. I mean, I don't care if they cross their heart and hope to die.
Well, there was an interesting article in Popular Mechanics on that whole thing, and it was last month. It's worth reading because they say that the Japanese came up with a jet at about the same time that the Germans did,
mm-hmm.
and they theorized that after all their research that. This was a Japanese craft. Now, whether it was flying or whether it was a balloon and the jets were used for steering, I don't remember. But
see, that's very interesting. And an interesting thing like that, you want to know more about it, and you'll pass them along and discuss them with your friends. And I guess that's a possibility.
But, you know, part of it is people just want, I think that they just, sometimes they just get bored with everyday life. All these labor-saving devices, maybe, or something, and so they've got to. They don't read very much, perhaps, or maybe some of them do, but they read all in one area, and they want to ventilate their minds and keep their facilities sharp, and they do it by entertaining these wild notions.
Yeah, the thing about the bargain sports car where the guy's supposed to left town with his secretary or with a woman and then called his wife and said, sell my sports car and send me the money, and she put an ad in the paper and sold it for $50.
Yeah.
the first time I heard about that, it was in Reader's Digest in one of these joke columns.
Yeah.
And suddenly that became true. That became true, like the lady said, yeah, go around and paint my back porch and I'll feed you. And the guy later said, that's not a porch, that's a Ferrari or some such thing. And they're funny and we want to believe them. We want to pass those along.
Stranger than fiction.
Oh, yeah, much stranger. I got to go, big boy.
Thank you.
You take care.
You too.
1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back.
This is Rich Simpson from the sales department of the Fun Seekers Radio Network. Regular listeners of the Ludlow Porch Show know that Ludlow gets calls from all over the Southeast, from South Georgia to the mountains of Tennessee and North Carolina, and over to the Piedmont area of North Carolina. Regular advertisers on the Ludlow Porch Show know from experience the value and benefits of the exposure their products and services have received. We live in a mobile society. The person you hear calling in from Cleveland, Tennessee or Hickory, North Carolina today may be traveling through Spartanburg, South Carolina or Statesboro, Georgia tomorrow. Not to mention inquiries over the phone. The possibilities are endless. Let the Fun Seekers Radio Network go to work for you. Call me, Rich Simpson, at 404-256-4749. That number again is 404-256-4749. Expand your customer base with the Fun Seekers Radio Network.
Well, the rumors are true.
Talk to Doll Baby on the radio. Hello, Doll Baby.
Good morning, Lolo.
How you doing?
I'm still trying to get used to that name. I'm like the guy that just called you. I wasn't so sure what all of your conversation was about this morning, but I did hear the one lady talk about responses and, you know, people's reactions during the full moons or new moons.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I used to work for about 17 years off and on in nursing homes.
Mm-hmm.
And I can tell you can always tell when the new moon or the full moon was coming in because people did act differently.
Yeah, you hear that from doctors and nurses and people in emergency rooms and people like you from, you know, nursing homes and policemen.
Yeah.
Different world out there when the moon is full.
It's strange how some of the people, especially, you know, the elderly people would react. It would just amaze you. You could just look at each other. The workers would just look at each other and say, oh, my God, what's going on?
You always said the same thing. Well, the moon is full.
Yep. Exactly that. Another thing that happened, this could be a story that you could use even on your show for like a whole day's show, is just different stories that you'd hear from hospitals and nursing homes about things that would happen.
Yeah, full moon things, yeah.
One of the things we had a ghost in our nursing home, and it was called, and it came from a patient who had been there. And that person was determined that they were going to haunt us forever because we didn't do totally what he had asked us to do. We had to go by what the family had demanded.
Now, what makes you think there was a ghost left over when he shuffled off?
Well, we had the person in there aggravating and haunting us for almost 3 years, and I'm serious.
Well, now, tell me what they were doing and how you know it was a ghost.
Well, because that person died there. That's the first thing.
Okay.
And then it wasn't long after that all the different little incidences started happening.
What kind of incidents?
Like wheelchairs rolling down the hallway without a person.
That'll do it.
That was one of them. and all the patients' wheelchairs were always put in their closets at night, so we knew they didn't go for that. So we and the gals, and this was always at the night shift too. It never happened during the day. And we lost one of our best head nurses because of all the incidents that happened. And of course, the company didn't want to believe anything like that would happen. So they, just to get the rumors and get everything stopped, because it was starting to upset all the patients, because the patients started seeing it, and they wouldn't sleep at night. So they finally had some ghosts for the people who will come in and eliminate the
A ghostbuster.
A real ghostbuster. They came in and tried to find out why this person was so unhappy, and apparently they got some results out of it, because after this person did their soothsaying in there for three different times, we never heard anything more about it again.
All right.
Strange.
You take care of your sweet self.
All right, you too.
I'll talk to you soon.
All right.
For the best eye care anywhere, gang, it's the Fairbutt Eye Clinic, 770-964-3391. Ludlow and Denny, we'll be right back.
Forces with First National Bank in Elkton. We stand still with the same folks from Tri-County Bank that we've always been. We're under the same ownership with the same great banking. So why all the fuss? Try convenience. As Pinnacle Bank, we now have 8 offices that makes banking with us easier than ever. So stop by and check us out. You'll see why we're the top bank in town. Pinnacle Bank, Royston office, member of FDIC.
And we got more of the Ludlow Porch Show coming up. We do invite you to stick around for your gospel favorites as we'll get into lunchtime in about an hour from now, and we'll have all gospel music for you from 12 noon right on up till 6 o'clock. Don't forget, folks, we are signing off at 6 o'clock. That goes into effect today, so we'll have about 6 hours of some great gospel music, some almost continuous gospel music coming up for you from 12 noon right on up till the 6 o'clock sign-off time here on WBIC. Looks to be another fair day. It's going to be kind of hot out there. Our temperature right now, 83 in our listening area.
Looks like some low cloud cover and some fog this morning. Otherwise, today, partly cloudy skies with only isolated afternoon thunderstorms. It's going to be a warm, muggy day with a high in the low 90s. A pretty much typical mid-July day for us. Overnight fair down to lows in the low 70s. Tomorrow, partly cloudy skies with scattered afternoon thunderstorms, highs in the low 90s. And on Wednesday, partly cloudy skies, a chance of an afternoon thunderstorm, but a bit cooler, a high in the upper 80s. From the Weather Channel, this is meteorologist Mike Spinnerford.
I heard the Weather Channel man talk about a storm that we might get that might come through our area around 2 or 3 this afternoon. We're going to kind of try to keep an eye on that and kind of update you on any information that becomes available when it does. For now, fair skies and our current temp, 83 in the listening area, WBIC.
This is the Ludlow Porch Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, broadcasting from the Falcon Inn and Conference Center in Suwanee, Georgia. The little show brought to you in part by Taylor Construction Company, call them and never paint again, by Breakthrough Septic System Cleaner, and by the Blue Willow Inn, gracious hospitality and superb southern food. The toll-free lines are now open at 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, fun seekers. Hi, y'all out there in Radio Land. What a great day to be alive. Ludlow and Denny on the Fun Seekers Radio Network as we ease our way into our final hour for the day. We're talking about myths, those stories that...
How you doing today?
It's going well, thank you.
You have a nice weekend, I hope.
Great one.
All right, well, one of the things I wanted to bring up was one of the things I was told as a child, a folk sally.
Yeah.
And the booger man.
Yeah, it's kind of, they brought those up for the same purpose, to keep us in line.
Yeah, I believe that's true.
Yeah.
And but you know, those things always worried me.
They were supposed to.
And you know, they would. I know they had to help in my later years. They would. I realize now that they would run a sheet by the window or something. You know, somebody outside. You know, make sure you saw it. You know.
Anything to alter your personality.
Right. And you talk about phrases, how they get turned around. In my 20s, we used to play a game at two teams, and you'd start off, the little red fox was white, and you had to tell it to the person next to you, and the person next to you, so and so. And by the time you got down to the end of your team, it never did come out what started off.
Yeah, yeah, always changes. If you were listening to our friend Edgar a few minutes ago talking about the Doberman in the elevator.
Oh, yeah, okay.
You see, he said that was Michael Jackson, and originally that started out as Reggie Jackson and then went to Jesse Jackson, and that pretty well made the rounds.
Well, it's just strange how, I myself, I believe Elvis is dead.
Yeah.
I know he's dead.
Yeah.
You know, it's against the law to fake the funeral. And if they ever got caught with as famous as he was, it'd be chaos.
Yeah.
Everybody was going to fake their death. Just to get the insurance money, I guess.
I guess.
But I had to throw my 2 cents worth in on that, and I'm going to listen to the rest of the program, see if I can learn.
All right, big boy.
You have a nice one.
Good to talk to you.
Always here.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255, Knoxville, Tennessee, and Big Ed on the radio. Hello.
Hey, Ed.
How you doing, Ed?
Well, I'm on probation now. I think they're passing today.
Yep, yep.
Before I tell you about the myth, I want to tell you something.
All right.
I was driving horses up in Canada, and I didn't know if they got a picture of it. They sent it to me, and he says, "Dear Mr. Lee, you look like you just saw Dolly Parton with her top down."
Uh-huh. How many horses can you jump over, Ed?
How many horses? Yeah. How many feet?
You said you were jumping horses. How many do you jump
over? No, I jumped a horse over a jump.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, about 4.5 feet.
Okay.
But the expression on my face is what he was talking about.
Okay.
I'm a man, I tell you, I've got your address.
All right.
Mr. Bill Witch over in Middle Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
Ever heard of him?
Yeah, that's familiar sounding. Tell me about the Bell Witch.
Well, we stopped at this country store. We were going out there. The man says, now at sundown, the Bell Witch will come out and ring that bell that you used to have out in the country to call him dinner.
Yeah.
And he'll come out about sundown. So we got over there. And no, no kidding, man. I'm not lying to you. He cried it up. The wind started blowing. We didn't see a witch, but oh, it was here. I'm telling you.
But you saw some bad weather.
We saw some bad weather, right.
Okay.
Like these home remedies.
Yeah.
You see this black woman on the ranch. When I got sick with a chest cold, she put sulfur and grease on it.
Mm-hmm.
And then like mayapple and ginseng, my great-grandfather used, he didn't have the same with aspirin. But now it's been through and it works sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the home remedies will go way back and then they kind of take on a life of their own. I'm glad you called, big boy. You take care of yourself. 1-800-572-8255. More conversation right after this. And Thomasville is on board. Hello there.
Mr. Porch, how are you?
I'm great, old friend. How you doing?
I'm getting older every day. Trying not to.
Okay.
Fight the fight. Years ago, in a little town I grew up in, we talked about the fire woman. She was supposed to be able to talk fire out of you if you got hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I thought that was a myth until it happened to my little cousin. Myth turned to fact.
Yeah, I had an aunt who was big into that.
Mm-hmm.
We were out. Of course, she was nuts.
Well, this one was too. She'd crawl around.
We were out someplace walking in the woods looking for something. I was going to help her get some woods dirt or something, and she slipped down and skinned her knee on a rock. Now, you got to bear in mind, I'm about 10 or 12, right?
I understand.
And all I'm fit for is to carry that dirt out of the woods. And she started talking to her knee. She bent over and started talking to it. And then she said it was all right, and we got up and left, and I thought, whoa, I'm out of here alone with my great aunt, and she's got a screw not touching
that. Animals in the tree.
Yeah.
Well, let me mention something that you talked about last week, the UFOs.
Yeah.
I won't recall the county yet that I grew up in, a little town, but got a lot of friends to listen to you in that area. About our 11th grade year, my best buddy and I decided we wanted to go rabbit shining one evening. And we found two young ladies that wanted to go with us.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure you're aware of that.
And how would I be aware of that?
Well, I've listened to you for some time, and you're a very bright man.
Okay, I'll say no more then.
Let it lay where it lays.
Here, here.
And we noticed what we thought was swamp gas. We were on Oak Gunner River Swamp and paying attention, and the more we looked at it, it turned into a UFO.
Yeah.
The more we watched it, it turned into an IWO, which stands for Identified Walking Object.
Uh-huh.
And the closer it got, it wound up her daddy, who was the game warden.
A bad, bad sign.
Bad move on the kid's part,
nothing,
I guarantee you.
Nothing good's going to come out of that.
But that's my only experience with the IWO, so you have a pleasant day, sir.
You take care of yourself, and I'll talk to you soon.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Breakthrough Gang helps keep your septic system working properly and odor-free for less than $50 a year. 1-800-572-8255 is our number as we go to Spartanburg, South Carolina, and talk to Jotoo on the radio. Hello, Jotoo.
Yes, hello, Ludlow. This is an interesting program, and I haven't heard all of it. I mentioned to Denny the genre of apocalyptic literature or writing. Has anybody mentioned that?
No, no.
I think this might fall into the category. For example, Hal Lindsey's The Late Great Planet Earth, a bestseller back in the 70s, if I remember correctly. I had a copy of that book at one time. I've loaned it out and hadn't got it back. You remember that?
Yeah, generally, yeah.
Okay, it was a bestseller, and I was talking to a friend over the weekend. He said they're still selling that book, and now we have another book in that genre on the New York Times bestseller list. Are you familiar with it?
No, what is that?
All right, let me preface this. In 3 weeks, it is moved from 14 to 5 to 3 on the list, and this week it's holding its own in number 3 position. The name of the book is The Bible Code.
Oh, yes, I have heard of that, yeah.
Oh, okay. Another friend over the weekend said he heard it being discussed on TV. I missed that, and I have not seen a review. Have you seen a review of this book?
No, I know what it is, but I have not seen a review.
Uh-huh.
But this is supposed to be the code that we have received, right?
Yes, and it's a technical book, Ludlow, based on the research of a mathematician who says there is a code in the Bible, and on the cover, I'm holding the book in my hand right now, got it out of our library, mentions Yitzhak Rabin, assassin that will assassinate, and they say that this was predicted in the Bible through this code, and that they warned Rabin about it before it happened, and then it happened. So anyhow, I just mentioned that, and maybe it can be discussed later.
Yeah, we're gonna hear a lot about that book, and my only thought on that, having not read it, and I guess I should read it before I comment on it, but. If we believe that the Bible is the inspired word of God, it's obvious to almost anybody that he wanted to make it as clear as he could without any codes involved.
Yes, and that's the point. Can I finish with one little quick thing here?
Yeah.
There's a cartoon in the paper last week about, let's see, this colonel or this important-looking military man is saying, look, we're informing you conspiracy nuts that no UFO crashed at Roswell and no alien bodies were found. This old guy's holding this sign. Roswell really happened. And he says, yeah, right, and why should we believe that? Then there's another picture, no words in the last line here. Because that's what Elvis told Bigfoot on the grassy knoll, and this guy throws his sign away, and he says, well, why didn't you say so? Talk to you later, Luke.
Hang in there, big guy. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. I want to talk to you about the Blue Willow Inn. Listen, I want you to forget everything you have ever known about Southern cooking, ever known about buffet dining. I want you to try the Blue Willow. The setting is absolutely beautiful. It's in a completely redone, remodeled, beautiful mansion in Social Circle, Georgia. The service is exactly like you would want, exactly like you would expect, and the food is out of this world. Out of this world. The Blue Willow Inn. Put that on your list. It's in beautiful Social Circle, Georgia, and you tell them Ludlow sent you. I want to talk to you about my buddies at Taylor Construction. Tennessee, and LD on the radio. Hello, LD.
Hello, Ludlow.
How you doing, pal?
Just fine, you?
Good, thank you.
Okay, what I was calling about, these two or three people told me that those tabs on Coke cans or soft drink cans, if they separate them and, you know, get enough of them, they're more worth about $40 a pound. Just the tabs.
Yeah.
Heard anything about that?
Yeah, I heard the same things you have. I've heard if you saved enough of them, you can get somebody a C&I dog or do something nice for somebody disabled or something.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yes, sir. That's it. But they all kind of run together after a while.
Yeah. I didn't know whether there's anything to that or not.
Well, if you can get $40 a pound for them, that might be worth thinking about.
That's true.
I'm glad you called. How's everybody in Sweetwater?
Oh, just fine.
Good talk to you.
Good talk to you. Thank you.
1-800-572-8255. You're one of those things that makes the rounds. Rome, Georgia. And speaking of somebody makes the rounds, here's Jim. Hello, Jim.
Getting better all the time, Ludlow.
It is getting better.
Oh, you know, you're talking about the aluminum tabs.
Yeah.
Those things used to be part of the people droppings that you found along the highway and in overlooks and
yeah, you could follow a family on vacation by just following the tabs.
Yeah, I wish somebody would start a rumor about styrofoam.
You know what I want to know about styrofoam?
What is that?
When they ship it, what do they pack it in?
Yeah, that's a good idea. It's like the universal solvent. What do they put it in?
Yeah.
You know, as a former pilot, once a year, and I'm sure it's the same with other pilots, at least once a year, I have to hear a story about a guy making a gear-up landing, and his excuse is that the gear warning horn was making so much noise he couldn't hear the radio warning.
I love it.
How many times have you heard that?
I've never heard that one.
You know, and I'm tempted to say, yeah, that was me, and I spent an hour in the wreckage waiting on ambulance.
Yeah, and you put that you're in the Guinness Book of World Records because of that.
Yeah, I just wonder if John Boy down there in Walton County has ever heard that one.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. Now, you remember about the finger in the can of asparagus?
Yeah.
And there's a lot of these stories that you hear that you hope are right, but of course down deep you know they're not.
Oh yeah, a lot of them. We want to be true.
Well, it's like the woman with the walking her dog with her little plastic bag and carrying her pooper scooper.
Yeah.
And this ne'er-do-well comes running down the street and snatches it out of her hand.
Yeah.
And runs off. Then the big question is, what did he say when he opened the bag?
Oh, well, that's the only part of that. That's the only part of that story that the average fella can associate with is when he opened it up.
Yeah, and then there's another one where a guy thought he killed a mountain lion and he just stunned it, but he had stuck it in a foot locker or something. And had, but he's laying on the side of the road and these people come along and saw a chance to steal something
Yeah.
In other words, they opened that locker inside their car and the lion come to life.
Yeah, that's very much like the one that's really made the rounds. where the guy takes his wife deer hunting, and he, and the punchline of this, and you've heard it. I know it's your deer, lady. Just let me get my saddle off of him.
I haven't heard that particular one, but I love it.
Well, I've heard that from three or four different sources.
And, of course, the thing about the scuba diver, you know, being picked up by the forest.
Yeah.
I flew a fire helicopter out in California one fire season, and this bucket had a electric-operated valve in the bottom, and I've heard of a couple of cases of people doing that, picking up a fish or two, but I never heard of a...
Yeah, as a matter of fact, when I read that story out of that magazine, you called me about that. I remember vividly, and you said that wasn't true.
Couldn't be. No way.
And I think I responded by saying, it's in the book.
Now, there's a deal about these old wives' tales, and of course, you know how I feel about being politically correct.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, these snapping turtles that won't turn loose until a thunderstorm comes up.
Yeah.
I picture people all over the place calling weather stations, asking when the next thunderstorm is coming. You know, that stuck their finger in a snapping turtle.
Yeah. I put in one of my books, I don't know which one it is, about how I believe that. And the thing that scared me the most was that I knew as a little boy that we'd go sometimes weeks without any thunder.
Yeah.
And I could picture my mama dressing me up, taking me to church on Sunday with a snapping turtle on my finger. And I was so afraid of public embarrassment, everybody would say, look at that little idiot, picked up a snapping turtle.
Yeah. Now, of course, I know I'm going to have to leave you in a moment because my work is done, but don't forget about cats drawing lightning. You have to keep that in mind.
That's all, sucking a baby's breath.
Yeah, well, I'm off.
Take care.
All right, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back.
WBIC Royston, it's 11:30.
Such an ordeal. I mean, something you just dread doing. Well, I'm not going to try and tell you that buying a new car, Jasper, Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler.
No. So he told me what you said. And you say three little engines came down from heaven. One brought frost, one brought fire, and one came to take the fire back again. And you're supposed to say that three times, and that's what they say to talk fire.
Okay. You see, my Aunt Jill, and my Aunt Jill believed in everything like that.
Well, you know, old people believed in this.
She wasn't old, she just nuts.
Yeah.
But who
in the world?
She believed in curses, that you could bring somebody bad luck. All that kind of, she believed in fortune telling and cars and reading the bumps on people's head and tea leaves and crystal balls and all that.
Yeah.
And lots more.
Well, was y'all talking about Glenn Miller a while ago?
Uh-huh.
Did anybody bring out about what really happened to him?
Well, we talked about that a couple of days ago. They're talking about now some rumors that we've heard two already today that he actually died in Paris, but everybody knows he didn't get to Paris. Another one was that there was a prostitute on an airplane with him, and that's all foolishness.
Well, Paul Harvey told it in the rest of the story. Now, if it's not so, then it's Paul Harvey.
You mean about the English fighter planes dropping
yes.
a bomb, Jim?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that may be getting pretty close to documented. I think that may be true.
Well, you know, there was talk of him going to search the English Channel for his plane. And then this came out, and Paul Harvey told that about that time.
Yeah.
So I figured that must be the true story.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, that was all I wanted to tell you was about the fire. I
After I found out what to say, I know there's nothing to it.
Okay. The more you find out, the more you doubt it. I got you.
Uh-huh.
You take care of your sweet
okay.
self. I'll talk to you.
All right.
Bye-bye. Bye. Dalton, Georgia, and Dot on the radio. Hello, Dot.
Yes.
How are you?
I have a true ghost story.
A true ghost story.
I know it's true because I know the person. I know they wouldn't lie. Anyway, back in the 70s, this person was transferred several hundred miles to another location for her job.
Mm-hmm.
And the apartment she rented, there was much noise and garbage trucks going by at 3 in the morning and all that. So her employer agreed to pay rent on another place. So she found a place out of the city. It was an old, over 100-year-old renovated house. And she thought, well, I found quiet and peace finally.
Uh-huh.
And she said that when she would go to bed at night, this noise would wake her up, and it would sound like a cement block dropped from the, dropped down and bang, bang, bang in the front bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a little twin-size bed in there that had been redone. It was over 100 years old, and she kept her ironing board in there and did her ironing, but she said that she absolutely could not sleep, said she'd wake that noise would wake her up at night, and said the cats would be all spooked out and the dog would be laying sound asleep, and said the lampshades would be shaking, and she said, I thought I was going crazy. I was afraid to tell anybody.
Yeah.
And finally, it got so bad, she just didn't get any sleep and had to drag into work the next morning. And she finally confided in a coworker. And the coworker told her of this lady that studied stuff like this and says, now you go to her and you tell her what you've told me. So she did. And the lady told her, says, now you go home and you write this ghost a letter and you tell the ghost that you have got to sleep, that you don't want to harm it in any way. And I don't know exactly what all she wrote, but she said the next morning she went in there. Now the windows were all down. There was no breeze blowing in that room. And the letter was laying on the floor. And she looked up and she seen a puff of smoke go through the window. And the window was down. And that was the last of her ghost.
Did she mail the letter or just leave it there?
She just left it laying on the bed because that was the room where all the banging and noises was coming from. She even had her central heat and air checked out, you know, thinking maybe it might be making some kind of popping noises. And she won't tell anybody hardly about it because they don't believe
yeah.
it, but it actually happened.
Okay.
And let me tell you this little short thing. It won't take but a minute.
Got to be less than a minute. Hurry.
Oh, okay. I had a relative. You remember back when Covington Ga cheese came out?
No, it's been here long as I can remember.
Time. Well, she went to the store and bought some, went home, and looked at it and carried it back to the store, and she told the man, said, I want my money back, said, this cheese has got blood in it. That's a true story. I'll let you go.
You take care of yourself. And where would you mail a letter to? What would you say in a letter to a ghost? 1-800-572-8255. More conversation right after this.
Right now, this very minute, thousands and thousands and thousands of people are listening to the Ludlow Porch Show. The Ludlow Porch Show is broadcast on many AM and FM stations in large markets and small towns in 6 states in the Southeast. Listeners know the Ludlow Porch Show to be gentle, humorous, interesting, and one every listener can enjoy. You can reach all of these listeners with the story of your product or service.
The friendly ghost, the choo-choo man from Dallas, Georgia. Hello, Choo.
Hello.
How you doing, bud?
All right. Good. Well, what would you say in the letter? You'd say, get out of here with that doop-de-doop yeah. before I call the cops.
Very good. That's as good as anything.
I don't know whether this was took from a true story or not, but Red Sovine, he could do a song so real and so scary and so sad, whatever he wanted to do, he could do it.
Yeah.
You know? And he had one, Phantom 309. I bet you probably heard
it. I have.
And it sounded, it sounded like it could be a true story about a truck driver that, you know, got killed in a bad wreck.
Yeah.
And then where he wrecked, if there's ever a hitchhiker along that stretch of the highway, Big Joe was his name. Big Joe would pick him up. And he'd carry him down the road a little ways to the first truck stop, and then he'd give him a dime for a cup of coffee. And then he'd disappear.
Sounds true to me.
You know, I don't know whether that's a true story or not.
Only thing that makes me suspicious is about getting a cup of coffee for a dime.
That wouldn't work today, would it?
Sure wouldn't.
No. And the trucking bozo has only done one album, a country album.
Uh-huh.
And he's got a song, Daddy, What You Doing Out There? And he tells about this truck driver where a bridge has washed away.
Yeah.
And his daddy has been dead several years, and he is standing out in the middle of the road just before he hit that bridge. Now, that was the scary. He got stopped, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then he disappeared. So I don't know whether that comes from a true story or not.
Well, or from a true tale.
Yeah.
Or from a tale, period.
Yeah, but now that's scary, Lud.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. A lot of this stuff's scary.
I know it.
Yeah.
I know it. That's and I'd have moved out of that old farmhouse.
Yeah, a ghost starts dropping.
Right fast.
A ghost starts dropping concrete blocks, I'm out of there.
Yeah.
He got one block.
Well, I told you about the old house, you know, that we went to that night when we was going to plow all night with the tractor.
Uh-huh.
And the door opened and shut back real hard. I mean, it slammed so hard, Luddy, that dust fell out of the wall for that old house. And we'd always heard it was haunted. And sure enough, I believe it was.
And that was it.
Well, that's when I left the house.
That's what I mean.
Uh-huh.
You take care of your bad self.
I got out of there as quick as I could get out.
I'll talk to you, buddy.
And it went out another door. It didn't go in the door that slammed.
No, made you a new door.
Yeah.
Choo-choo, take care of yourself, buddy.
All right.
I'll talk to you. Taylor Construction Company, gang, you call them and never, ever paint again. 1-800-572-8255, Brunswick, Georgia, and Jim on the radio.
Oh, Ludlow, how are you this morning?
I'm fine, big boy. You okay?
You say it's hot and muggy in Atlanta?
Oui.
Well, you see, when it's that way down here, we don't recognize it as being such because it's that way so often.
We just ignore it.
Yeah, we just ignore it and live with it. A little story that happened to me that I'm not much on ghost stories and don't believe in the supernatural very much, but something happened to me that has always puzzled me. When I was 11 or 12 years old, I had terrible, terrible warts on my hands, both of them. And they were so bad that I had already gotten up in age to where they were embarrassing.
Mm-hmm.
went to a little town in Georgia, central Georgia, called Uvalde to visit relatives one summer, and a little pharmacist there. The little man was, Parton Pharmacy. We were at the soda fountain, and he looked at my hands, and he asked me if I'd like to get rid of those warts. And, of course, I thought he was joking and said, sure. He said, I'll buy them from you. And I don't know what he gave me, a nickel or a dime a piece or whatever. And these were terrible things. They would even bleed sometimes. And he rubbed those warts and gave me the money. Of course, we spent it immediately at the soda fountain. And he told me that those warts were going to go away. And I took it with a grain of salt. And lo and behold, they did. And I have never had them again. And that was, I'm 58 years old.
You know, I've heard so many stories like that about getting rid of warts that it makes me think that there's got to be something mental about this.
I don't know, unless he convinced me he did tell me, I remember, because I went back the next summer without my warts, and I talked to him, and we laughed, and I even know one of his grandchildren lives in Glenn County here to this day, and we talk about it. He told me to think about them. Just think about those warts and think about them going away. And I did for two or three days, and lo and behold, the next thing I knew, they were gone.
Yeah. We've all heard similar stories, and I've almost come to the point of believing that almost anything will get rid of warts. I've heard about the wart witch, you know, that you give them they give you a nickel or a penny. Or, you know, that's the same sort of story.
The thing I remember most about them, Levi's were real popular, and we wore them skin tight.
Mm-hmm.
And I would wear these rub these warts raw, trying to put particularly my right hand in my Levi pocket, and it's so tight they bothered me. And they went away. I know I'm taking up your time.
No,
the warts went away.
Interesting story. Interesting story, and I believe it because
I bet you your listeners, somebody in your audience remembers that little pharmacist. He was a little short man, and I bet they've had the same experience.
I bet.
Thank you, Ludlow.
All right, buddy, call us again. 1-800-572-8255. More right after this.
You've seen septic system products advertised on TV, and they're probably okay. But new Giant Breakthrough is better because it does three...
Those fingers in my hair that sly come hither stare that strips my conscience bare.
Wicked witchcraft. Let's talk to the guy with his hand up. Hello, big boy.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, pal?
Just fine.
Good.
Where do you think those warts go?
Bye-bye.
I just had a terrible thought just now. What if you're walking down through the woods and you're just all of a sudden just covered in warts?
That's awful.
Well, what you could do. I was in the Ghostbuster business.
Were you really?
Yeah, when I lived in Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
And we would just hire a couple of winos, and they would go out and, like, haunt a place for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'd just drop a few business cards, run an ad in the paper or something, and had all the business we needed.
And you send your guys away someplace else.
Right. And then we'd just move to the house next door. So, we'd just move them out of that house, you know, and then we'd just go down the street.
Yeah, I love it.
It was a pretty good scam.
It's a free enterprise system in action.
And that's right.
Well, okay.
That's as far as it goes, I guess.
Right, that's all right. You don't need a punchline all the time.
Well, get Denny to tell you that little joke that he told me a while ago.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
I'll ask you. You take care of your bad self.
Hope you have a big Christmas.
Thank you, sir.
See ya.
Bye-bye. Marietta, Georgia, and Don on the radio. Hello, Donald.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
I just want to tell you first, I appreciate y'all's clean program.
Thank you.
About the wards, I got a story, but a quick story, but I wanted to say about the warts. I think they're kind of like mouth ulcers. You can either put camphophonique on them for 7 days and they go away, or you put salt on them for 7 days and they'll go away. I think you just do about anything for 7 days and they just go away.
Any 7-day activity gets
that's
your,
right.
I like
right.
it.
I kind of like the fishing aspect myself.
Yeah.
Fish for 7 days and they'll go away. It's
exactly,
a good excuse.
Exactly. I love that. I'll play golf.
There, it sounds good too. I just wondered if you had anybody called in, talked about an experience they had of fireworks after an intimate relationship or such.
No, we've been blessed. We hadn't heard a word about that.
Well, this was a possibility. You might get a call. Years ago, I was raised in the country, and I was on my way back from Alabama getting some fireworks. And nature called, so I pulled off real quick, and there was a old house sitting back in the weeds and with a tin roof. But there was a car parked there, and me and a friend were getting out, and we noticed this car parked there, and all the clothes were piled on top of the car.
Mm-hmm.
So we kind of figured what might be going on, and figured there may be in that house. So we had just bought some fireworks, so we shot a few bottle rockets off the tin roof of that house. And didn't know if anybody called in wanting to talk about their experience or not.
No, but if someplace there's somebody wanting to tell that and they're afraid to.
All right.
You take care of yourself. Right. I'll talk to you.
Thanks.
All right, gang. Had a big day. Not enough time left to get to another caller, but we'll just tell you that we've had a good time, and who knows, we may do this again one of these days. I'm not sure how much we learned, but we heard a lot of good stories, and I think we've heard about some things that that probably can be explained, like the scuba diver of the get-down lady in the elevator with the dog. I think those are just so much fun to talk about that people pass those on. And we all hope they're true because they're funny. All right, we're gonna get out of here and make room for your local station right back with you in the morning. And we hope you'll be on board between now and then. I want you to do me a favor. Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Music and the news, weather, and sports. Tune to WBIC 810 AM, Royston, Georgia.
Now, the top local news from the station you trust. News Talk 750 WSB, Atlanta's news, weather, traffic, and Braves station. Depend on it.
Good afternoon. I'm Lisa Nicholas. Our top local story this hour.
This occurrence represents that final chop which brings this tree down.
An update on a developing story in a case that waited 26 years to go to court. A mistrial has been declared. WSB's Richard Sangster is live with the latest in the Jan Barry Sandlin trial.
Yeah, Lisa, grim-faced Judge Hilton Fuller told the court that Jan Barry Sandlin may never be tried for killing four-month-old Matthew Golden. The Tracy Rain, the young baby's sister, violated the judge's rules not to read, view, or listen to anything having to do with this trial here in DeKalb Superior Court. Rahm watched her mother's testimony on court TV in Savannah.
It was too much to expect this young woman to ignore not only her mother's testimony, but all of the commentaries. In her words, and I quote, "I have spent my entire life waiting to hear this testimony."
Now, Judge Fuller said he hopes Rahm gets some satisfaction knowing she was able to get the case into court and that she was not responsible for her baby brother's death. The gag order is still in effect. Judge Fuller will listen to arguments that Sandlin be retried, and there'll be a change of venue if he is. Reporting live from DeKalb County Superior Court, Richard Sangster, News Talk 750 WSB.
Atlanta temperature at 1201, 83 degrees. Today, partly cloudy and hazy with muggy skies, high of 86, a low around 71. This news brought to you by Applebee's. Other stories we're following for you this hour. Communication with the Pathfinder lander on Mars was cut off today. A computer aboard this spacecraft reset itself again as it was sending back pictures. They'll try to reconnect later today. On board the Russian space station Mir, the commander is showing signs of heart irregularities. He's questioning whether he'll be able to participate in the upcoming repair mission. Police in Hall County are looking into a chilling murder at Lake Lanier. They're searching for two teenagers believed to have helped plan a robbery and murder of another teenager, two suspects already in custody. Landmark secondhand smoke case underway in Miami. The class action suit by flight attendants accuses tobacco companies of hiding the health threats of secondhand smoke. And Braves hosting the Phillies tonight. News Talk 750 WSB coverage begins at 6:07 on your exclusive home of Braves baseball. On Wall Street, the Dow Jones Industrial Average up 20 points. WSB News Time, 12:02, weather and traffic, plus more of Dr. Laura just ahead on News Talk 750.
It's summer fair now at Applebee's, with salads as cool as...